elections like it's not a thing. Somebody please expose the fact. It's going back to one party. They call President Bill Clinton a whoremonger. Voted him out and replaced him with a warmonger. It's like a jumper sometimes. I'm at the front of the line. I ain't tripping, but I stumble sometimes. Then I get right back up. Then I get right back up. It's like a jumper sometimes. I'm at the front of the line. I ain't tripping, but I stumble some time. Then I'm... Talib Kweli.
Yeah, Kweli.
Dr. West, you want to say something about that, about that track?
I want to just thank everybody for coming out. I want to thank Jan Offman for being kind enough to provide this opportunity. And most importantly, I'm always blessed to be with my dear brother, Tavis Smiley. Tavis Smiley, I don't know how many of y'all saw that presidential debate on Thursday, but what this CD is all about is precisely to try to, for me, to keep alive the best of the legacy and spirit of Curtis Mayfield, of Gil Scott-Heron, of the Last Poets, of Stevie Wonder, and that's when music actually stirred your soul. It didn't just stimulate your body. And I'm trying to get young people to understand that they come from a rich tradition of music, a profound tradition of music, in which music is not simply a mode of amusement and entertainment. It's a way of life. It's a way of struggle. It sustains your soul as you wrestle with adversity. Circumstances, so they can understand a Lester Young when he engaged in that elegance of earned self-togetherness and stick-to-itness against adverse circumstances playing in the foxtrots of Ellington. There's a tradition of young folk that need to understand that this hip-hop culture is a moment in this richer tradition, and that's why when you hear what Talib is doing, why somebody like Prince, who in so many ways is the musical genius of his generation. James Brown is now gone. Yes. George Clinton's still around, thank God. He wants to be on the next CD. That's cool. But Prince is one of he's the last one standing, and he's never allowed his music to be used on a hip-hop album until now, precisely because he understands what this project is all about.
And so speaking of Prince, why don't we play a little bit of the track?
Again,
this is the first time Prince has done this. He's written music for the folk, but to be on somebody else's CD is not what Prince does. But he so regards and respects Dr. West as we all do here. This is this next track featuring Dear Mr. Man.
Dear Mr. Man.
Featuring
Cornel
West and Prince.
I want to send a heartfelt thanks to my dear brother Prince. He shows deep love, and I embrace it. He is the artistic genius in our midst. He is a musical artist among us. Raise your Socratic questions to the system. Bear witness to justice against the system. Be true to who you are and be true to the grand vision that keeps track of the least of these. Break it down, Brother Prince.
What's wrong with the world today? Got to get better.
I told Dr. West, it's like, you know, Prince's voice is so inimitable and so distinct. First thing you hear when he goes that, and you know Prince is coming, don't you? You want to talk about the track with Prince now?
Yeah, I mean, we reflected on this, is that which particular song we wanted to do and how we wanted to do it. And he was so open to being explicit in his critique. And at the very end of the song, we really go into quit lying to justify war, quit torturing folk around the world. It was over and over again. It was just a blessing to work with the brother. It's just so much love. And one of the things that the album is really about is the question of Roberta Flack and the great genius Donny Hathaway raised back in 1974. Where is the love? Where is the real love? When you really love folk, you hate injustice. You can't stand folk catching hell. You really have righteous indignation. You see the wretched of the earth being treated the way in which they are. And Gina is just the peak of an iceberg in this regard. And young folk beginning to wake up now, to becoming more and more hungry. That's why, even when I talk about this album, I'm not just talking about this, I'm talking about Talib's eardrum. We're talking about Common, Finding Forever. We're talking about KRS-One, and then one of Dead Prayers. We're talking about Rhymefest, who's also on here, because it's not just about this one album. I'm an older brother. It's about opening up possibilities for new voices among the younger generation so they have the same kind of vision and courage that has allowed them to be where they are and the level of sacrifice of those who came before so they can be where they are. Once young folk lose a sense of history,
yes,
they're in deep trouble. They're in very, very deep trouble.
One of the last things that Gerald ever did
Rusty Linda's voice to this particular track on this new record, Never Forget, The Journey of Revelations by Dr. West. So here's a track featuring our distinguished guest today, Dr. Cornel West, and the late great John Levert.
Mm-hmm. Nobody like him, nobody.
Talking about a funky situation, unaccountable police power. I got to bring in some partners here. The lyrical rapper, Wayne Wayne, the towering genius of the rhythm and blues artist, Gerald Levert. Help us reflect on this, brother Gerald.
Oh, lately I've been thinking about the world that we're living.
Gerald, sound good, don't it? Gerald, sound good. God rest his blessed and precious soul.
Yeah, Wayne Wayne, rapper, comes on the piece. We're just a few seconds away from it, but listen to that track, and then Wayne Wayne breaking down what happens to brothers who get caught driving while black. We're going to start to see this in just a second. You might have to give just a little piece. Some of the police are black women here.
A little bit of Soul Sister.
There's a Soul Sister. What track is that? Number 12. Give a little bit of 12. Soul Sister. Just a little bit of this.
Just a little bit.
We're going to make you get your CD soon.
Yeah, because let's take you back home right here, though. Bubblegum music. You know what I mean? It's cotton candy music. This is the kind of music that stirs the soul. That's why there's a group called the Soul Stirrers that produce a genius like Sam Cooke and another one like Lou Rawls. And we're trying to get back to this music because the quality of the music has so much to do with the quality of the souls of young people. And these days, the music is just so thin. It's so impoverished. It's all about stimulation and titillation and really about nurturing and caring and empowerment and knowing and enablement. We need a younger generation who is well-equipped to take the struggle for freedom and justice and love to the next level. And we got too many of them to caught in the distractions. And the music has always been fundamental for that kind of sustenance. Because show me a black people who have a thin and impoverished black music, and I'll show you a black people who no longer love themselves and respect themselves and affirm themselves and have enough self-confidence to take a stand and take action with courage and compassion. And so this is a connection of a music linked to education. People say, well, you're a professor, why are you engaged in music? Music has been fundamental for my life. I write 17 books. That is readable education. These CDs are about a danceable education.
That's Cornel West. West Coast Society CDs. Thank you. Have a good day.
We love you. For Brother Travis Smiley.